Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. To your younger brothers and sisters who would want to take up engineering in the future, and to your relatives. That's one way you can keep me going inspired and refreshed. Now, if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also, please don't forget to subscribe. Hello students, subscribers, viewers, and future engineers. Here are exercises in calculus. And I put it in Vitamath. And this is for those who have already through with their calculus courses. Then, if you want to anticipate the solution to these problems, you can by pausing the video. So, evaluate limit of the quantity absolute value of 2x minus 1 minus absolute value of quantity 2x plus 1 all over x as x approaches 0. So, this is of indeterminate form. And it is because x approaches 0, the denominator approaches 0. Now, remember that the definition of absolute value of x is equal to x itself if x is greater than equal to 0 or if x is positive. And it is equal to the negative of x if x is less than 0 or if x is negative. Remember, absolute value of a number is always positive. So that if x is negative, negative of negative, it will be positive. Now, as x approaches 0, common sense, you have to look at the expressions. Only the first term could be negative inside. The second term is positive as x approaches 0 because this is 2 times 0 plus 1, so it is always positive 1. So that the absolute value of 2x minus 1 for the possibility that it is negative because x approaches 0 is negative of 2x minus 1, then 2x plus 1 remains unchanged. So that is equal to limit as x approaches 0 of negative of quantity 2x minus 1 minus quantity 2x plus 1 all over x. So we have negative 2x, negative 2x, and negative 4x. Negative of negative 1 is positive 1 minus 1, 0. So simplifying, it would be negative limit as x approaches 0 of negative 4x over x. So we can cancel x here, so we have to expand first and simplify. So limit as x approaches 0 of negative 4x over x, so we can cancel x, and that would be limit as x approaches 0 of negative 4, which is negative 4. So therefore the answer is negative 4. For the second problem, find all values of a such that f is continuous on R. So if f of x is defined piecewise, we have x plus 1 if x is less than equal to a, and x squared if x is greater than a. For the function to be continuous on R, the limit must exist as x approaches a, and the function value also exist, and for it to be continuous, the limit as x approaches a and the function value should be equal. So that is f of a, because these are linear functions, this is parabolic, there's no denominator, there's no expression or symbol that will make these expressions of indeterminate form. They are continuous functions actually. Then We say that the limit exists, the function value exists, and we should equate them. So f of a is a plus 1 equals a square, and this should be equal, the limit should also be equal to this. A plus 1 equals a square, the limit of x plus 1 as x approaches a is a plus 1, and the limit of x square as x approaches a from the right is also a square from this expression. Therefore, equating and rearranging, we have a square minus a minus 1 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. So a capital A is 1, b is negative 1, and c is negative 1. So the quadratic formula is a is equal to negative of b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac all over 2a. So negative b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac all over 2a. So substitute a is equal to quantity negative of negative 1 plus minus square root of quantity negative 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 1 all over 2 times 1. So the value of the radical is 5. So we have square root of 5. This is 1. So a is 1 plus minus square root of 5 over 2. So a therefore is 1 half plus minus 1 half of square root of 5. So that's it for the second problem. For the third problem, if limit of quantity f of x plus g of x is 2 and limit of quantity f of x minus g of x as x approaches a is 1, then find the limit of f of x times g of x as x approaches a. So as x approaches a, then the limit of quantity f of x plus g of x is equal to f of a plus g of a, and it is equal to 2. And for the second limit as x approaches a of f of x minus g of x is 1, so f of a minus g of a is equal to 1. Adding to eliminate g of a, so we have 2 f of a equals 3, so that means f of a is 3 halves. Substitute into this equation, no problem. So 3 halves plus g of a equals 2, so that means g of a is 2 minus 3 halves, and g of a is 1 half. Then we substitute into this expression here, f of x times g of x as x approaches a is f of a times g of a. Since we have found f of a and g of a, substitute, then we have 3 halves times 1 half, then it is equal to 3 fourths. So that's it for this video. I hope that you were able to follow the explanations and the solutions, and you are also convinced. And for those who attempted to solve this problem, I hope that you also got the correct answers.